Good evening. Rugby league is a tough arena, but the people involved in the game are as vulnerable as anyone in our community. First grader, State of Origin player, as well as a premiership winning coach, Paul Green has taken his own life, aged just 49. Tonight, the devastating loss is being mourned by his family and the rugby league world.
Police outside Paul Green's Brisbane home, where this tragedy played out this morning. The 49-year-old found dead by his wife after she returned from school drop-off. An old teammate delivering a message from his devastated family.
On behalf of the Green family, today we are devastated. We have lost a devoted husband, loving father and a wonderful son. We cannot find the words at this time that will come close to expressing our feelings. However, we would like to express our thanks to those that have reached out to us with their love and support.
Today we've lost a truly special member of the rugby league family and we're all deeply saddened by it.
In a glittering career, this was Paul Green's golden moment. The day the Cowboys rode into town and showed their big brothers, the Broncos, how to win in the most dramatic of ways.
Thurston to choose from with Coote. He hits it. He's got it. He's got the field goal. He's got the premiership.
It was a victory that reflected the way Green lived his life. A little man triumphing in a big man's game. Cowboy turned Tiger James Tarmow lost his coach and his words.
Devastated, but just trying to... I don't think my mind can sort of take it in yet. As you said, he was obviously a massive part of North Queensland's first premiership. He was the one that obviously put it all together and made it work.
What are your memories of him, mate, as a coach?
He just loved the game. He loved the game of rugby league. He gave it his all.
Just 5 days ago, Green was celebrated by the club he played most of his football for, the Sharks.
Yeah, plenty of good memories and great to catch up with all the old boys today. It's been a ton of laughs and really well done by the club.
He reached the pinnacle as a player at Cronulla. While the individual honours were large, he was always a team man. Last Friday, he caught up with his old teammate, Matt Rogers.
I can't believe it. I literally cannot believe it. I just spent, you know, a great few days with Greeny down in Sydney, played New South Wales golf course together. He was telling me about the new boat he just bought for his, you know, for him and his family to be able to, you know, get out on the water.
A knee injury cost him a title with the Roosters in 2002. He was supposed to be Brad Fittler's halves partner.
Did everything possibly in the game you could do, and he's going to leave a huge hole.
Away from the game, his hobbies were varied.
There's so many things out there that you can experience and you won't know unless you sort of have a go.
And the sky was his saviour, first learning how to fly a plane.
There's Shark Park just down there, that brown building.
Then a chopper. It's where he found peace away from the pressure of football.
That's a great way for me to switch off and sort of be in the moment, I suppose, and not think about footy.
But more than anything, his greatest role was a husband to wife Amanda and a dad to his two kids, Emerson and Jed, who had a birthday yesterday.
They keep you grounded. My daughter's right into dancing, so, you know, now and then I become a dance dad. So I was out in a Stedford just before we caught the plane last week down.
You haven't got any moves, have you? Like, you're not teaching any dance moves? Or?
I've tried to bring out the sprinkler and the shopping trolley. But yeah, kids are a great leveller.
Green's next chapter was about to be locked in, assisting Wayne Bennett at the Dolphins. He'll now be honoured with a minute's silence at every NRL game this weekend. Danny Widler, Nine News.
If you are struggling with your mental health, please talk to someone. Ask, are you okay? Take a friend for a coffee, a walk, confide in your GP, share your feelings with your family. Just talk to someone. You might be surprised how many people you know have the same struggles. You are not alone. One of the best places you can call is Lifeline. They are there to listen. They are there to help. Here's their phone number. 13 11 14. 13 11 14.